Finally, the Elite Dangerous Guardians update is out, and it's quite amazing, I have to say. There are a lot of new features, a lot of new content. And let's start with the ship-launched fighters, which is my favorite, I guess. Also, the menus are a little bit redone, like the outfitting shipyard and stuff like this is on this side. If you go into shipyard, we also have ship transfers now. It shows where my ships are. And you can transfer the ships for a fee. But I find these times absolutely ridiculous. If I would do it manually, if I would go in there and fly that ship manually from there, it will take me definitely less than that time. It will take me maybe like, I don't know, half an hour with this crappy ship. But 1 hour, 31 minutes, that's a little bit too ridiculous, I'd say. I don't like this. It should be like realistic times, how... based on, you know, how much the ship can jump and stuff like this, but nevertheless, it's here. The ship transfers is here, and from here, I actually said I'm gonna start with ship launch fighters, but that's okay. We finally have the storage thing for the modules. You can click on transfer options and you can store your module just like that. It's free, and ta-da, it's in the store. Stored modules, you can go from here and you can use whatever you want in here. So you can even store multiple. You can select, I guess I can go in here and select like this what I want to store. And the storage size, as you saw, is 60. You can store 60 modules. I'm not sure if it's in one station. I assume it's in one station, but I'm not sure. I haven't checked it. And the ship launched fighters, we have to buy the bay. I have bought this ship fighter bay just for testing, and you have few different fighters in here. They are all the same on this station. Somehow you can buy the other ones, like the Condor and whatever the other ships were. They come with different guns, as you can see, fixed plasma, la 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 la. And once you buy them, then they are ready to go. You have to go into the crew lounge and hire yourself a crew member. You can get them from here. Also, one thing, they said they fixed the icons not showing, but as you can see, for me, they're still black. You have to hire a pilot. I hired two pilots, but for some reason, I'm not sure why I can't hire like two of them, because I have two ships. Why can't they launch two ships if I have two ships? That's a bit confusing, but I'm guessing that one of the ship hangars can only launch one fighter, even though it has two of them stored. It can only have one active. At least I couldn't find a way to actually have two of them active, so... And we also have passenger launch, which is for passenger missions. You have to buy the module, of course. Well, here are some passenger missions, stuff like that. Why is that so much? 200 light years away? That's actually pretty close. I thought it's a lot more interesting to launch the fighter actually on the planet's surface, so I'm gonna try if you can. So you press the number 3, tab thing, you select the fighter. You can actually select a lot of things. You can see your crew and stuff in here. But you go into the fighter section, or, well, all, it doesn't matter. And then you find the fighter you want. I want the one with plasma. Click on it, you can deploy. And then you select if you're gonna fly yourself, or you assign your crew member. I'm gonna fly it myself. Yeah, you can. So the crew member takes over your... So your crew member takes over your mothership, so... And that's how you fly that thing. And the ship, it should follow, I think, as far as I know. I'm gonna stop for a second and see. You can give commands to the mothership, orders, and then we can give positions like... You can see it, you can read English, I guess, so. But on some reason, when I tell it to hold the position, it starts doing stuff. I don't know why. It tries to hold the formation, see? It goes into the formation, even though I want to hold position. It starts doing stuff, see? It tries to, like, be in the formation, so I don't know. And this is how it shoots. That's the plasma repeater. It has infinite ammo. It shows 30 out of 30, but it keeps refilling, so... And look at the speed of this thing. This is ridiculous. Like 500, holy crap. I know how far you can go from the mothership. I haven't actually tried, but it's amazing. And it's really maneuverable too, so it's pretty cool. Just fly this thing around like... Meow. Just hope the maniac is not gonna crash my ship. Talking about the maniac flying my ship. Oh, this is so awesome. Look at that. Woo! I am loving these things. They're so maneuverable. I like that. Oh shit. Gravity. Kinda forgot I'm not in the space anymore. Even though the gravity is almost non-existing still. It's there and it's dangerous. Because this doesn't have wings like the normal planes, so it kinda has small wings, but well, there's obviously no air atmosphere in here, so you can actually use these fighters to take out small bases on the planets, I'm guessing. And also, which brings me to that they say they have added geysers and volcanoes or something like that. And biological entities, which is pretty interesting, but I don't know where to find them yet, so. These are my lights. Whoa, shit. Okay, I'm gonna try to stop for a second. And show you the fighter from outside. Well, that's how it looks like. Really tiny thing. Imperial fighter. It's pretty cool. I do like it. It's pretty awesome. Too bad you can't customize them. Would be nice if you could customize them yourself. There's my ship coming. Well, let's look it from this angle. I still don't know how far you can go and what happens if you go too far. I guess it's just trying to, like, you know, be close to your fighter or something. I'm not sure, but yeah, he's just sitting there. Now he's holding position. And to talk with this thing, just like with stations, you have to first request talking. Where's the talking thing? Whoops, wrong button. You go into, well, you just click on the helm, which is your mothership, and request talk.
The bay is prepped for arrival. Take it in slow, Commander. Friendly fire isn't, Commander.
Friendly fire isn't. Isn't what? Huh? Well, anyway, that's how you talk. You have to go, like, from behind. Behind. That's came out wrong, but that's okay. Like I said, the same kind of principle as with stations. And on the last second, somewhere in here, now it took the control over. Now I can't control it anymore. So you don't have to worry about, like, doing it exactly. You just have to fly slowly into that corridor and it takes over your ship. And that's it. Well, I was too close, but I don't know what's going on in here. Look at that. It's just parked ship in here. I know what's going on here. Look at that. There's something going on here. Some drones and stuff in here. Oh shit. They're shooting at me. Why? What did I do? I'm gonna get out of there better. Wait, he's shooting at my ship? Why is this shooting at me? What the heck? Oh sh! And they also changed the interior. Looks like they're different now. I mean, more different ones. This station had these orange ones, but now it's red and it looks like Darth Vader's bit or something. There are different stations, but this one was definitely changed because that's like my home base and they've changed it a lot. Oh, I wasn't looking, I was looking around. And if the fighter blows up, then nothing really happens.
Systems offline.
Oh, shut
our
up.
Facilities are at your disposal, Commander.
See, this was the fighter that blew up, and now it's 14 out of 15, so it, I can reconstruct another fighter. The heck? Oh, there's a ship landing. So that's how the fighters work. There's another small update. If you're gonna jump into a system, it actually shows you above now. Low security and you're clean. So it shows like a little bit more status. So it's good to know that you're not jumping into a system where you're wanted. So that's good. Well, I'm going to show you those geysers that were added. And one of them is on Actea. And I think I found the geysers. At least it looks like it. So I'm gonna try and land in there. Yep, definitely. Look at that. Yeah, I can see it's suitable, but I wanna land in the middle of them. I'm gonna put it in third person. Look at that. Go through it. Straight through it. Okay, I'm gonna land right here. Stop. Stop. Stop, you stupid ship. Wait, everything is fine? Okay, let's go down then. Let's do this. Is there another ship? Are you kidding me? You better not attack me. I'm gonna close the game. I don't care. Why are they harassing me? I don't get this. Okay, that's them. Sorry, I forgot the buttons. I was just testing for a second. Oh yeah, look at this. That is nice. I don't know if it damages anything, but let's just take a real close look at this thing. This looks like a poop hole. There's some texture bug. Oh, what? Oh yeah, I forgot. You can go under the planet. Look at that. You can see inside the planet like this. They need to fix this thing. That's kind of lame. Ruins the experience. But that's how they look like. That looks like volcano, really. Not water. It says it's water geyser, but look. This is what I saw. I saw those small things flying from the distance. This is nice. That's really beautiful, guys. These are really nice. This is not volcano. That's normal. Look at that big one in there. It actually looks pretty big from the distance, but... And there's also some crystalline cluster in here. I don't know what this is, but I'm gonna try to blow it up and see if it gives anything. What the? Where's it going? It's flying into the space. Come back. Hey, come back down. Down to the earth. Yeah, this planet has almost no gravity. It's like a potato. Like a giant space potato. Look, that thing, it just won't come down, back down. Well, there are a lot of bug fixes and additions to this update. But these are the main features. The update itself, I think I said it was 13 gigabytes. So it's a lot of data and stuff in here. But these are the most interesting things, like the ship launch fighters, the geysers, biological entities, which I have no idea about. And they also said mysterious things, which is, well, it's interesting. I really like it how the tracks like remain for quite a long time, as you can see. But I will definitely come back to it if I find something worth showing, so stay tuned and I will see ya next time.